The body of Mordred Garcia, the Filipino killed by a co-worker in Saudi Arabia, has been flown home. Our very own Victoria Tulad now joins us with that story. Victoria, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, the remains of slain domestic helper Mordred Garcia have been brought back to the country this morning. Garcia was killed by her African co-worker in Saudi Arabia last September 16, and the crime was relayed to the Philippine government only on September 27. Overseas Workers Welfare Administration Chief Arnel Ignacio said the co-worker was allegedly jealous of Garcia because she was very much liked by their employer. The suspect is already in jail in Saudi, and Ignacio said they will be waiting for justice to be given to Garcia. The OFW's grieving mother and husband were also at the cargo terminal to receive the remains. Garcia, her family, and OWA personnel are now traveling to her hometown in San Jacinto, Pangasinan, where her wake will be held. She is survived by her husband and two children aged 6 and 9. According to Ignacio, OWA will give Garcia a hero's welcome. Her family will also receive assistance, which includes a check amounting to 220,000 pesos for funeral and burial needs. They will also give them 15,000 pesos as livelihood assistance and scholarship for one of her children.
President Marcos gives his assurance government will bring home the bodies of two Filipino caregivers who were killed in the Israel-Hamas war. Vivian Gulia tells us more.
On Wednesday night, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. made two of the most difficult phone calls he had to make as president. He called the families of the two Filipino victims in Israel to extend his condolences. He said the government will provide utmost support to the family they left behind and that it continues to stand for peace. At least two Filipinos were confirmed killed in the attack launched by Palestinian militant group Hamas on Israel. One of them is Filipina nurse Angeline Aguirre, who was lauded by Jerusalem Deputy Mayor Flor Hassan Nahom for her loyalty and humaneness. She refused to flee without the elderly patient she was caring for.
A wonderful hero called Angeline, who was taking care of an old lady called Nira in the kibbutz. There was a moment when she could have escaped, but she stayed with the old lady that she was taking care of, and they were both brutally murdered.
Angeline's family was filled with grief for losing a loving daughter and a thoughtful sister. Her sibling Wilma says Angeline just got married last September and had planned to start building a family when she returns for a vacation next year.
Nga po yung gustong-gusto niya na pong mangyari, na gusto niya na daw pong magkaanak po, ma'am. Kasi may edad na din po siya.
The long-awaited family reunion for Filipino caregiver Paul Vincent Castelvi has also been shattered after he died in the surprise Hamas attack on Israel. Paul Vincent's mother says he had planned to return to the Philippines this December for the first time in 5 years, but now they will have to celebrate Christmas without him.
Sana po, kung sino man po yung may gawa sa akin, sa anak ko na yon, nawa po, higit pa sa nakamtan ng anak ko yung ginawa niya. Magagawa sana po sa kanya. Patawarin po ako ng Diyos.
The Filipino community in Israel is loved and appreciated, according to Jerusalem's deputy mayor. That is why she says Israelis also mourn for Filipinos murdered in the attack.
There are so many people in this country that owe the Filipino community so much that for us, it's as painful to lose one of you as it is to lose one of us.
Philippine Embassy officials are coordinating with Israeli authorities for the retrieval of the bodies and for the search of three more Filipinos who remain unaccounted for since the Saturday attack. Authorities are also verifying through DNA testing reports of a possible third Filipino fatality. The crisis alert in Gaza has been raised to level 3 amid the fierce fighting between Israel and Hamas, according to an official of the Department of Foreign Affairs. This means that the government is calling on Filipinos to consider voluntary repatriation. The rest of Israel remains under crisis alert level 2, which restricts non-essential movement for Filipinos and suspends deployment of overseas Filipino workers. DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega says alert level 4 or mandatory repatriation will only be raised when there is a large-scale internal conflict or full-blown external attack. There are some 30,000 Filipinos in Israel and 137 in Gaza. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
A group of Filipino students returns to Manila after fleeing the violence in Israel, Jose Carretero reports.
More than 50 students who took a postgraduate agro-studies in Israel arrived Thursday at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Among them is 26-year-old Lloyd Vince Herrera. He is thankful they are back home away from the conflict. Their dorm in Ashkelon is just 9 kilometers away from Gaza, where Hamas militants continue to launch missiles across the border.
Pag nagkaroon ng rocket barrage po, talagang kami po yung unang, sa amin po yung unang nag-a-alarm. Tapos yung airstrike po ng Israel para sa Gaza, every 30 seconds po naririnig po namin. May bomb shelter naman po dun sa ano namin, tinutuluyan. Pag nag-siren po, tatakbo na kami dun sa baba.
Herrera said a rocket once landed near their flat, traumatizing the students.
Ramdam po talaga namin yung ano, yung may trauma po kami pag may mga kumakalabog, ganyan.
Javis Faulan from Camarines Sur said they are supposed to return to the Philippines on October 10, but it was postponed after militants bombed the airport.
Nakakatakot po kasi nung Friday, payapa, tapos pag Saturday, ayun na, nagising kami, madaling araw, umaga, non-stop na yung bombahan.
Norby Carino is also grateful they're out of danger, saying the situation in Israel is frightening.
Masyado po kaming thankful kasi nakabalik na po kami ng matiwasay dito sa Pilipinas. Kasi mahirap po doon sa Israel, masyado pong ano, napaka-delikado kasi may nagkalat pong mga terorista.
Most of the students say they will no longer return to Israel despite the good job opportunities. Another batch of students will also be returning this week. Meanwhile, families of students still in Israel are worried for their safety. One of them is Professor Helen Manalastas of Bulacan Agricultural State College.
Sabi naman po niya, huwag mag-alala. Kaya lang po, siyempre, baka po yung mga ibang terrorist ay nakalibot na sa ibang lugar. Yun lang po inaalala ko.
Meanwhile, for cousins Christian and Lexter Villacorta of San Ildefonso, Bulacan, who graduated on September 6 for their postgraduate studies in Israel, it's a mix of relief and regret. They are comforted by the fact they're back in the country, but disappointed by the lost opportunity to work in Israel.
Sa ngayon po kasi medyo malala ngayon kasi yung nakapasok ko yung sa border, yung mga, yung Hamas nga. Dati po kasi puro ano lang eh, rocket. Nadedepensa naman.
Nakakatakot po kasi ngayon.
Pero maganda sana opportunity doon.
Po, maganda po sa Israel talaga. As po. Yun nga po yung mga kalaban po nila.
School officials of the Bulacan Agricultural State College where these students graduated believe all is not lost since the training they received in Israel will help them land good jobs in other countries. Jose Carretero, ABS-CBN News.
Another government agency falls victim to a cyber attack. This time, it's the Philippine Science and Technology Department. The DOST says it has already launched an investigation and that measures have been implemented to address the incident. Cybersecurity experts say the group behind the hacking of DOST is the same one that attacked the Philippine Statistics Authority. That group also claims to have hacked its way into the Education Department and the National Police's Forensics Group. According to government's initial probe, the hackers are likely based in the Philippines.
Kaya siyang agapan eh. Education ng mga employees, huwag lang tayong click ng ano-ano. And then second, yung ba't hindi natin binabudget ang cybersecurity? Ang at-risk talaga is any agency na merong platform na exposed to the internet. Eh, yung something in common eh, dito sa mga agencies na tinamaan.
A magnitude 5 quake rocks Batangas. The tremor also felt in other parts of Luzon, including Metro Manila. Let's get an update from our correspondent, Dennis Datu. Dennis, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, an emergency meeting was conducted here at the command center of Calacas City, Batangas, led by Mayor Nas Ona, together with other disaster officials, after a magnitude 5 earthquake shook at past 8 a.m. Many residents felt extreme fear due to the intense shaking of the ground that they experienced. Employees of the city hall quickly evacuated the building and headed towards the roads for their safety. Calacas City was the epicenter of the earthquake, but based on initial reports, no damage had been received yet in buildings, schools, roads, and industrial plants. However, the disaster officials led by city engineering team are still conducting inspections on buildings, particularly schools. face-to-face classes at all levels in public and private schools in the entire province of Batangas have been suspended to allow for the inspection of school buildings. Batangas Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction Management Office Head Dr. Amor Calayan said that some students from St. Grace Community High School in the town of San Luis were taken to the hospital after experiencing panic attacks, while another student from St. Mary's Education Institute in the town of Lemery lost consciousness and was rushed to the hospital. As of now, the situation here in Calacas City has returned to normal, with electricity supply and communication lines are still intact. Calacas City has a population of 85,000 and consists of 40 barangays. There will be another meeting this afternoon at the command center to report the additional information they will gather regarding the said magnitude 5 earthquake. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Dennis Tato there joining us on the line. Take care, Dennis. A movie version of a record-breaking world tour and a star cinema film with a Hollywood treatment. Manny, the movie guy, tells us which one is his pick of the week.
Welcome to the Eras Tour. Taylor Swift takes on the film industry in the Eras Tour, the movie.
Extraordinary experience of my entire life.
Producing the film herself with no studio help, the Eras Tour concert movie is going to break box office records.
The adventure is going to span 17 years of music.
Filmed over three nights during Swift's six-show sold-out run at SoFi Stadium in Los Angeles, the concert movie is made for fans, the main character of the film, as she told us. Some songs are omitted and some given importance in order to fit into nearly 3 hours of spectacle.
To the acoustic setting.
Director Sam Ranch, who gave us Billie Eilish live at the O2, captured the concert brilliantly, putting you front and center.
Are you ready for it?
You will have a blast, whether you're a Swiftie or not. Karma is her last song in the concert, but you'll be paid with a feel-good vibe. For that, Taylor Swift, the Eras Tour, the movie, gets 3.5 out of 4. Are you ready for it? Kisses. And to celebrate Filipino-American History Month, there's a very good girl.
Totoo ba talaga lahat yun, ma?
The film pits Filipino box office queen Catherine Bernardo against BAFTA and Golden Globe nominee Dolly De Leon.
Jobs for thousands of Filipinos.
The less you know about the movie, the better.
It's about two women going head to head against each other.
What does Catherine Bernardo's Philo want from Dolly De Leon's mother, Molly?
Takot. Delikado na to eh.
From director Peterson Vargas, the movie is campy, funny, but heartfelt, thanks to both actresses who help elevate the material.
We're all very grateful to be here, you know, to showcase Philippine-made movie. So, yeah, I'm just very proud.
I hope that they get a taste of our culture.
It's a dog-eat-dog world.
The soundtrack, the fashion, the acting, they're all right here.
And sa lahat ng mga nakapanood na, maraming salamat. Yes, a very good girl, still showing.
Mahal namin kayo. Salamat po.
A big congrats on A Very Good Girl again, and it's a very good film.
Oh, hey, thank you, Manny.
And for that, A Very Good Girl gets 3 out of 4. Go watch it. Kisses. I'm Manny, the movie guy for ANC.
Ako ng buhay. Masama ba kung kailangan kong lumaban?